Good afternoon. My name is William Butler, and I've had the pleasure of serving as senior class treasurer. Students, today we celebrate the accomplishment of our school mission, which is to provide all students with educational opportunities through a challenging curriculum to meet the needs of a diverse school community. At this time, please stand and remove your hat for the presentation of colors. Pledge of Allegiance and singing. Oh, okay. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say, does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the
Ladies and gentlemen, please be seated.
Hello. My name is Stephen Moy, and as senior class vice president, it is my pleasure to welcome all graduates, parents, visitors, faculty, and esteemed guests attending this year's graduation ceremony. Our special guests include Carroll County School Superintendent Mr. Scott Cowart, Board of Education Chair Mr. Bryant Turner, Assistant Superintendent of Finance, Miss Delene Strickland, Director of High Schools and Assessment, Dr. Travis Thomas, and our Central High School and County runner-up, Teacher of the Year, Mr. Lee Burton. Our cluster principals here today are from Central Elementary School, Mr. Matthew Huckabee, from Ruville Elementary School, Ms. Marla Turpin, from Weisberg Elementary School, Ms. Lindsay Long, and from Central Middle School, Mr. Kelly Edwards. Central High School administrators are Principal Mr. Jared A. Griffiths and Assistant Principals Dr. Tabitha Ginther, Mr. Chuck Robinson, and Mr. Zach Cooper. Thank you.
Good afternoon. Once again, my name is William Butler, and I have been honored as the Central High School Class of 2022 Salutatorian. First and foremost, to all my fellow graduates, congratulations. As cliche as it may sound, we did it. We made it all the way. This is a huge milestone in all of our lives, and we should all be extremely proud of ourselves. That being said, I would like to tell you something that I believe is very important as we head forward into life. Sorry, I lost my spot, y'all. Okay. I've been whitewater river rafting on four different occasions, and each and every time I went rafting, I was horrified. I will ride any roller coaster you throw at me, no matter how big and scary it may look. But putting my life in the hands of a part-time garage salesman, part-time river guide named Spencer, who I met 15 minutes before, is a whole different story. You see, when you ride a roller coaster, you're fully strapped in. The ride will be the exact same every time, and you know for almost certainty you will be okay and make it to the end. But a river isn't so forgiving. A river is a different experience every single time you raft it. The river can be calm and peaceful or roaring and powerful. You might get hung up and stuck while the river flows around you, or you might ride through with ease. You never know what the river has in store for you as you head around a bend. Some people live for that feeling of uncertainty, but for me it is mortifying. And as we stand here today, I'm sure many of you fear the uncertainty that we face going forward. Right now, we are leaving the firm and secure ground of the riverside and heading into the unknown rapids of life. We are leaving Central and embarking on our own personal journeys. Many of you will go to college to further your education. Many of you will go directly into the workforce. Many of you will join the military and serve our country. And many of you are probably sitting here thinking, I have no idea where my river will take me. But I'm here to reassure you that no one does. No one can control the river. I can't, you can't, my river guide Spencer can't, absolutely no one can. But just because we can't control the river doesn't mean we should stop paddling. You see, when you go rafting, on the ride to the river, they have to brief you on every single way you can die in a river, which is a lot of ways. But the second thing they teach you is that you must keep paddling when it gets scary. If you stop paddling when your guide tells you to, you're a whole lot more likely to get hurt. Paddling when times get tough is maintaining hope. If you keep moving forward, or it keeps you moving forward. When you lose hope, you become stagnant. Life is going to get very confusing very soon, and I'm sure all of you agree that every decision you have to make right now seems like the most important decision you've ever made. But we must continue to move forward. We must maintain hope for the future. To quote the great Tupac, if you can make it through the night, there is a brighter day. Graduates, no matter how difficult and stressful our lives may get, we must keep on moving forward and keep our hope for a brighter day. Please remember that your struggles are always valid. If you can't work through the hard times yourself, do not be afraid to ask for help. It doesn't matter if you feel like other people have it worse or your problems aren't that big. You deserve help just as much as anyone else. So tomorrow morning, when you wake up as an official graduate of Central High School, never stop paddling. Thank you. Happy birthday, Lily.
Good afternoon. My name is Abby Cole, and I have had the honor of serving as the student body president for the class of 2022. I'm going to start this speech out by being brutally honest. I absolutely hate public speaking. It's not for me, and I can guarantee you that my 30-person public speaking class has in no way prepared me for the hundreds, if not thousands, that are here listening to me today. And while we are being truly honest, I have to say, I believe I spent more time throughout this year thinking about how I could get out of this speech rather than thinking about what I was going to say. That was up until a couple weeks ago. About a month ago, it hit me, just like I'm sure it hit all of you. We're graduating. We did it. Against all the odds, in the middle of a global pandemic that changed the world, we did it. It all really started to become real for me when College Decisions came out. And for me, this was a time filled with lots of anxiety. What or where you are going after high school is one of the most important decisions you will make in your lifetime. Thinking back on this time helped me realize what message I wanted to leave you all with today. Throughout this time, I had all sorts of people telling me, you can do anything you set your mind to, and I'm sure all of you have heard this phrase or similar. No matter how many different ways you've heard this phrase, what it boils down to is, if you can dream it, you can do it. But today, I'm not here to tell you to be a dreamer. I'm actually here to tell you to be the exact opposite. Shocking, I know. In the wise words of Shonda Rhimer, ditch the dreams and be a doer. In your dreams, everything is perfect, but in the real world, nothing is. You have to keep pushing, always reaching for the next opportunity, putting your best foot forward, because it's what you do. Sitting back and waiting on your dreams to catch up to you is wasted time. If we're being honest, you don't even have to know what your passion is or have a 10-year plan set in place, although it's completely okay if you do. What's really important is putting yourself out there. Just keep moving forward and never look back. Life isn't full of perfects, so I encourage you to try new things and meet new people. Not everything has to fit into some perfect mold. We're 18. I can promise you nobody is going to expect us to be perfect. And while I'm making you promises, I will make another one. No one, and I mean no one, has made it to where they are today by dreaming. They had to go out and accomplish the hard work to get to where they are. And yes, maybe they did accomplish those dreams, but do we really give credit to the dreams? No, we give credit to the individual who made it that far in life. And to follow that up, you may wake up 20 years down the road and find yourself living a completely different life than what you have in mind while you're sitting in your chairs right now. But you know what? That's okay, because you did something to get there, and that's what counts. You get credit for doing something to still be here, still keep going strong, and still making your mark on the world, one decision at a time. You can't sit there and dream your goals and ambitions into reality. You have to put in the hard work and dedication to accomplish them. This is why the thought I'm going to leave you with, as you to consider as you all start this next chapter in your life, no matter what route you take, is how can I be a doer in a world full of dreamers? I can promise all of you that your hard work and ambitions will take you so much further than just your dreams ever could. Thank you.
Oh,
sorry, everybody. You have to listen to me again. If you didn't catch on the first time, my name's Abby Cole, and I am also the class of 2022's valedictorian. Thank you. One thing that I love to do, as I'm sure all of you do as well, is to think back on some of my best memories. There's one story that always sticks out to me, and today I would like to share that all with you. I think it's safe to say that this class has always been full of pranksters just waiting to pull jokes on the next unsuspecting person. My kindergarten class is not to be excluded from this, and one day we decided we were going to hide from the teacher when she had to step out of the room for a minute. As I was running to get into my hiding spot, I tripped and face-planted into a small bin of wooden blocks. One of those blocks had a sharp edge that just so happened to hit me right below my eye. The class erupted into laughter, as any six-year-olds would do, until they realized that I was hurt, and then half of the class ran to the rescue. I had the most gnarly black eye I've ever seen, and it was truly an atrocious sight. It turned every color of the rainbow until it was finally healed weeks later. But if we're being honest, which seems to be my theme here today, the only thing I cared about was the fact that I got to wear makeup to the daddy-daughter dance the next day, automatically making me the coolest kid in the room. However, since then, there haven't been many times I felt like the coolest kid anywhere. Like in elementary school, when our grade made up a game and got the same game banned within a week. Or in fifth grade, when we apparently caused so many issues on the playground that they had to separate us between boys and girls. And I think I can speak for all of us when I say we definitely might have felt like the coolest kids in the room when we were middle schoolers, especially at the high school football games, when we would all gather on the same hill week after week to sit there and do absolutely anything but watch football. Or during the extremely intense Capture the Flag games, which I'm surprised we were still allowed to play after all the concussions our grade accumulated after just the 3 years we were in middle school. And we cannot discuss the awkwardness of middle school without bringing up the eighth grade dance, a time where absolutely nobody thought they were the coolest kid in the room. I have no idea how a room full of 13 and 14-year-olds and their parents is anybody's idea of how to have fun on a Saturday night, but for some reason we were all there. And then, before we knew it, we were high schoolers. We started the first day of high school nervous, confused, and if you're anything like me, probably a little scared it would be like the movies and you would be stuffed into a locker before the day was over. But to our surprise, it wasn't like that at all. Despite that, we figured out everything just like every freshman class does. And then, just as we were beginning to understand the ins and outs of high school, a global pandemic came along that forever changed our world. The shutdown came quickly, nobody expected it, and not many people knew how to handle it. For our generation, it not only impacted our friendships, but also our education. It was a difficult situation, especially to deal with in the middle of high school. I believe that if any group was at risk of giving up, it was ours. We were overlooked in the middle of everything, and then dealt with the repercussions of COVID during arguably the most difficult year of high school. But despite all of this, we prevailed and officially have the highest graduation rate of any Central High class. The class of 2022 did not let COVID define them. We came into our senior year looking for it to be somewhat normal, and I think that for the most part, we were extremely lucky. Our senior year football games were the most fun I had throughout high school. We had a jumbotron, fancy flashing lights, and just the joy of being together as seniors. We claimed our spots in the front of the student section, even if it upset some underclassmen, and I truly think we had the time of our lives every Friday night. We got to have senior skip day, prom, a senior prank, and now here you stand, waiting for me to get done talking so you can walk across the stage. Because despite all of the struggles and the bumps in the road, you did it. I think it is important to recognize, however, that none of us made it here by ourselves. We had the support of our family, our teachers, our administrators, and all of the other important people in your lives. So I encourage each and every one of you to take a minute today to let these people know how much they mean to you and how thankful you are for everything they did. And since I'm the one with the microphone, I would like to take a moment to thank my parents for always being there and for pushing me to be the best person I could possibly be. I truly could not be standing here today without all of your support. Before I finish, I would like to remind you all that we are not just here to get our diplomas. This will be the last time, for a long time, and maybe even forever, that all 260-something of us are in the same room together. So take a moment to reflect on all of the memories you have with the people in this room, because today is it. It's your last chance to let these people know the impact they have made on your life. After today, we are all preparing to move on to this next chapter of our lives. So just remember, in the wise words of Dr. Seuss, you have brains in your head, you have feet in your shoes, and you can steer yourself any direction you choose. Thank you again.
As principal of Central High School, it is my pleasure to recognize members of the class of 2022 who have been selected for outstanding honors. The following students were chosen for these accolades based on their academic achievements and their contributions to the school community. Our first honor is for the class salutatorian. The salutatorian is the individual who earns the second highest grade point average in their graduating class. This year's salutatorian follows famous salutatorians such as singer Connie Francis, John Legend, First Lady Michelle Obama, and actor John Wayne. This year's salutatorian has plans to attend the University of Georgia and study computer science. Please join me in honoring our 2022 salutatorian, William Butler. The valedictorian is the title given to the student who has earned the highest grade point average of all students in the graduating class. In keeping with the time-honored tradition, Central High School recognizes the student achieving the highest level of academic achievement. Central High School's valedictorian follows such famous individuals as entrepreneurs Jeff Bezos and Cindy Crawford. Our valedictorian will be attending Georgia Tech in the fall and plans to study mechanical engineering. Please help me honor the 2022 valedictorian, Ms. Abigail Leanne Cole. I want to take a moment to brag about this class of graduates. They will finish high school with a 96% graduation rate, the highest in school history. The class of 2022 has broken all scholarship records. At this time, there are still awards and scholarships being collected by our students, but I can report that the class of 2022 has been awarded nearly $6.5 million in scholarships. Seniors from this class are going to schools across the country, as well as representing Central High School at schools all over the state of Georgia. Many others have prepared for the workforce and embraced their opportunities at Central the past 4 years to position themselves to positively contribute in our community. The class of 2022 is ready to be difference makers wherever you go. The opportunity to be principal. The opportunity to be principal at Central High School has been a blessing. I want to take this moment to thank the parents of these seniors for trusting me with your children, the Central community for your continued support, the outstanding teachers who invested in you each day while trusting me, and finally, the best students on the planet for making my job fun and fulfilling. I cannot thank God enough for allowing me to be the Central High School principal for the past 8 years. There's no other class I would rather leave Central High School with than you. The following awards are traditionally given to recognize outstanding members of each graduating class. The first award is given to two students in the area of leadership. Our first recipient leads by example with a quiet demeanor. She earned the top score in the FFA Career Development Event of Dairy Cattle Evaluation and Management. She helps coordinate agriculture department lessons with Rootville Elementary School and helped organize Central High School Farm Days the last 2 years. She's a Governor's Honors Program participant and has won numerous FFA Public Speaking Awards. She currently serves as our FFA President. The second recipient of this award has been a leader who has served with integrity in class. He has been an active member of Beta Club, National Honor Society, the GHSA Student Athlete Advisory Council, and has served as president of Interact Club. In addition, he was selected by Sportsbook Live as the Georgia Athlete of the Week earlier this spring. The math department selected this student as the Outstanding Math Awards recipient, and he was named the West Georgia Region Positive Athlete in two different sports the past 2 years. Please help me congratulate the 2022 Leadership Award recipients, Ms. Charlie Beth Causey and Mr. Caleb Hayden Griffiths. The Citizenship Award is presented to students who demonstrate loyalty to Central High School. Simply put, the students receiving Citizenship Awards are willing to share their time assisting others without recognition. Our first recipient has been a member of the Central High School cross-country, track, and soccer teams. She exemplifies hard work and excels in the areas of math and science. As the soccer team captain, she was not only an excellent leader, but encouraged and motivated her teammates. Ashley Hart, her soccer coach, said, "Our soccer team needed a goalkeeper, so this student took it upon herself to learn the position, master the skills, and then became our starting goalkeeper. She is selfless and has always been willing to do what is best for the team." Our second recipient has a true love for learning. She has won numerous competitive events in FBLA and puts her heart into each and every club project. She worked hard behind the scenes for several weeks with a former student of Mr. Burson's to bring personal memories to his Teacher of the Year dedication page in the yearbook. Liz Beverly, the Beta Club sponsor, said, "She is service-minded, bringing in loads of items to send to soldiers and helping to deliver baskets full of snacks to healthcare workers in our community. She's always been among the first to volunteer when an opportunity arises." Both students understand what being part of the Lion family is all about and have certainly made our school a better place. Please help me recognize and congratulate the 2022 Citizenship Award recipients, Ms. Katie Elizabeth Kilgore and Ms. Sarah Elizabeth Jennings. This is terrible to announce, but Sarah Jennings woke up sick, and she's unable to attend today's graduation ceremony. So we nonetheless celebrate her accomplishments and are very proud of her. The Service Award is given to students who give from the heart yet expect nothing in return. These students lose themselves in service to others and have discovered great happiness in doing so. It is through service that we learn to work for a cause and not the applause. Our first recipient has been a member of FFA and has a strong personality. She works tirelessly to support the program and her teachers. She never thinks twice about the task. She simply gets the job done. She serves as vice president of FFA and has participated in poultry evaluation and extemporaneous public speaking. She was a governor's honors participant and plans to attend Georgia Southern and pursue a degree in audiology. Our second recipient has been awarded several notable scholarships, including one from the Rouse Foundation and the Alpha Pi Chi sorority. She will be attending Agnes Scott College, where she signed her letter of intent to play volleyball. Along with being an athlete, she enjoys singing in the chorus. Ms. Phillips, her chorus teacher, had this to say about her. She has been in chorus all 4 years, auditioned for honor choirs, has been part of the musicals, and served as one of our chorus presidents this past school year. She is talented and plans to minor in music at Agnes Scott College. She is hardworking, responsible, reliable, and overall a kind and joyful person. Hard work comes easily to these two ladies. Please help me recognize this year's 2022 Service Award recipients, Ms. Alexa Nicole Wagner and Ms. Bria Elise Mabry. These days, students attend school for 176 days out of the year. To maintain perfect attendance for 1 year is a huge task. To do it in the middle of COVID is another amazing task. Central High School is proud to announce there are two graduating seniors who have maintained perfect attendance for all 4 years of high school. I agree with you, Joe. Joseph's saying that's crazy. Please help me congratulate Jacob McInnes and Ms. Michaela Blakeney. Achievement, as defined by Google, is a thing done successfully, typically with effort, courage, or skill. Our three Achievement Award recipients have combined these qualities, bringing honors and accolades to themselves and Central High School. The first recipient is our star student, earning the highest score on the SAT in his class. He won the Daughters of the American Revolution essay contest on the local, state, and national level, which earned him a $5,000 scholarship. In addition, he was recognized as a Social Studies Department Award recipient during Honors and Awards Night in April. The second recipient has been accepted into Dartmouth College and has plans to attend to study English and history. She's a member of the volleyball team and the track and field team. She was active in Spanish Honor Society, Beta Club, National Honor Society. Outside of school, she works closely with Jack and Jill of America. Our third recipient was accepted into All-State course his freshman and sophomore years. He also made it to Governor's Honors his junior year. He has participated in several honors courses, served as a chorus officer, participated in musicals, and has sung in the Central Quartet since he was a freshman. This year he placed first in region in boys solo, quartet, and domestic extemporaneous speaking. He became state runner-up in solo and extemporaneous speaking. Please help me congratulate the 2022 Achievement Award recipients, Mr. Jonathan David Burns II, Ms. Dylan Nicole Dunson, and Mr. William David Smith. Our final award is the Faculty Cup. Each year, the faculty votes on one student who represents the best characteristics and qualities of the students in the senior class. Being chosen as the recipient of the Faculty Cup is the highest compliment Central High School teachers can give one of our graduates. Today's honoree exemplifies the qualities we look for in a Central High School legacy. This student goes out of his way to say hello to others in the hallway. This student is everyone's friend and genuinely cares about our Lyon family. To cap off his senior year, he was recently featured in the West Georgia magazine produced by the Times Georgian. His physics teacher, Mr. Brian Terry, said, "He's one of the best students I've ever had. He is gifted mathematically and has a work ethic that is second to none." His baseball coach, Coach Wesley Shiver, said, "His constant positive attitude and leadership skills are what makes him a special person. He truly amazes me. He is the epitome of what a person can accomplish when they have the right frame of mind and work ethic." As school principal, I have the privilege of seeing many amazing students walk through the halls of Central High School. The last 4 years, I've been blessed to have this young man as a Central student. His character, faith, and leadership make a difference in how he represents our school and my family. I couldn't be more proud of the student who exemplifies what it means to be a Central Lyon. The added bonus is that the faculty selected my son for this honor. Please help me congratulate Faculty Cup recipient Caleb Griffiths. Now for the most important stuff. Parents, guests, and students, the time has come to present these candidates for graduation with their diplomas. As principal of Central High School, I've been authorized to certify that these students seated before you have met all requirements set forth by the state of Georgia and the Carroll County Schools Board of Education for the documents they will receive. Parents and guests, each student before you has earned the highest honor Central High School can bestow. Please be courteous so each student and their special guest can hear their individual names called. The Carroll County Schools Board of Education Chair, Mr. Bryant Turner, will have the honor of reading graduation candidates' names. Students, please come forward to be announced and to receive your diplomas. Parents and guests, please hold your applause so everyone can hear names as they are called. At the end, we will be as loud as we want to be, okay? I appreciate that. Thank you. All right.
Abigail Leanne Cole, with highest honors. William Pierce Butler, with high honors. Jonathan David Burns II. Stephen Francis Moy. Emma Taylor Davis. Kylie Brooke Godby. Jackson Seth Gordon. Katie Elizabeth Kilgore. Azaria McNeil McClure. Arnold David Acosta Guzman. Rosa Ureli Acosta Guzman. Austin Cade Armstrong. Anna Bell Ayers. Kira Jordan Babs. Emily Lauren Bailey. Brian Alexander Bain. Marissa Caitlin Bain. Ethan Jeffrey Barr. Sydney Victoria Beecham. Connor Nathaniel Beers. Joseph Bell IV. Michaela Christine Blakeney. Kylie Alyssa Blankenship. Ariana Bocanegra Guerrero. Grace Patricia Bolden. Kelsey Joy Bogatis Hills. Blakely Madison Brown. Madeline Elizabeth Brown. Peyton Grace Bryan. Elena McKenzie Carroll. Charlie Beth Causey. Anna Grace Cheatwood. Morgan Michelle Coran. Caitlin Angel Marie Coppernall. Dylan Lee Coppett. Kyle James Dean. Aiden Wesley Donaldson. Scarlett Love Douglas. Dylan Nicole Dunson. Lucy Ann Eason. Heather Michelle Itzen. Alira Christina Ferris. Olivia Grace Faulkner. Lee Thomas Fleming. Maggie Elizabeth Frankham. Tara Louise Freeman. Molly Grace Gable. Brysley Jovita Galvin. Jairo Alexis Garcia Perez. Pierre Dominique Gigan. Christopher Gage Gray. Isaiah Bryce Gray. Olivia Louise Gresham. Brendan Alexander Greisbach. Caleb Hayden Griffiths. Emily Grace Grissett. Emily Alyssa Grizzard. Brooke Addison Groves. Alexis Chloe Haberland. Anna Rose Hall. William Asher Hamilton. Yatarvius Shanae Wicker Heath. Connor Joseph Henson. Hannah Joelle Hicks. Owen Thomas Hooker. Delaney Lynn Hunt. John Blake Ivy. Olivia Grace Jackson. Olivia Rayland Jennings. Sarah Elizabeth Jennings. Eli Scott Johnson. Abigail Grace Lee. Austin Wayne Lee. Bailey Madison Lewis. Bennett McGuire Little. Bria Elise Mabry. Jasmine Alexis Martin. Gracie Rochelle McKee. Seth K. McWhorter. Carla Yahira Morales. Jacob Steve Muse. Mackenzie Caracas Myers. Hannah Marie Newbern. Kayla Marie Nugent. Marissa Tian Palmer. Hyatt Alexander Parker. Lance Ryan Pascal. Alyssa Ireland Pate. Ashley Lynn Peak. Guadalupe Yanari Perez Juarez. Giovanni Alexander Perez Ortega. William Blake Perry. Daniel Christopher Phillips. Myra Ann Phillips. Taylor Nicole Phillips. Gracie Madison Porterfield. Clint Keith Rainwater. Caitlin Ann Raspberry. Madison Taylor Roberts. Ayla Danielle Robinson. Nathan Emmanuel Robles. Kellen Jace Rollins. Jacob Thomas Smitto. Aaron Michael Lee Sheffield. Preston Douglas Simpkins. Madison Joy Singleton. Destin Alexander Smith. Dylan Jacob Smith. Josiah Jacob Smith. William David Smith. Kaylin Brianna Spratling. Lily Elizabeth Steinseifer. Caleb Alexander Swint. Daniel Edward Taylor. Samuel James Thomas. Caitlin Jane Tucker. Ava Marcia Taylor Tyson. Garrett Charles Velez. Bianca Isabella Vinci. Alexa Nicole Wagner. Ametria Faith Walker. Preston Blake Walker. Stephen Gunther Walker. Jackson Lee Warren. Jonathan Patrick Weinman. Nathan Tyler Weldon. Eleanor Jean Clanton Wilson. Natalie Claire Wilson. Savannah Rose Yates. Grace Elizabeth Yoder. Tiffany Nicole Bice. Jacob Daniel Akers. Jacoby Dante Allman. Cynthia Sis Emerson. Wendy Pilar Arismendez Escobar. Jarrett Peyton Arnell. James Chase Attaway. Melissa Avila Cruz. Oscar Brandon Avila Lascano. Ashley Lynn Ayers. Levi James Baker. Clay Arnell Barker. Caitlin Simone Bethay. Angelo Joseph Bianchini. Alexis Jasper Blunt. Garrett Parker Booth. Bethany Ruth Brock. Adria Lee Brown. Abigail Marie Juan Lamperti. Ryan Marshall Callahan. Gracie Jules Camp. Manosha Capria Camp. Jesus Alberto Campuzano Sierra. Elena Lorian Carey. Brandon Lewis Corsi. Jasmine Chantel Daniel. Haley Mache Duke. Natalie Michaela Faulkner. Connor Jacob Fennell. Dakota James Foster. Jason Eugene Fuque Jr. Jesus Garcia Salinas. Daniel Lee Gibson. Ayusha Geary. Parker Shane Gore. Cameron James Grimsley. Aiden Lynn Hamrick. Gracie Lee Hamrick. Darius Juwan Haskins. Zachary Evan Hearn. Bailey Marie Heisey. Chaz O'Donnell Henderson. Ronnie Alexi Herrera. Madeline Kate Hewer. Joseph Alexander Hinch. DeAnthony Matthew Holland. Daniel Ray Hornbuckle III. Caitlin Nicole Horsley. William Matthew Horsley. Robin Raylene Hudson. Edwin Aiden Ibarra. Jessica Lynn Jackson. Jeremy Dakota Jarrett. Jasmine Aaliyah Jenkins. Mercedes DeAsha Johnson. Bradley Michael Kessler. Raquez Lorenzo Kite. Jacob Daniel Krebs. Canaan Lee Lands. Madison Grace Lands. Logan Christopher Langley. Matthew Slade Lathery. Allison Victoria Lloyd. Arlette Ciclale Luis Morales. Mark Amanya Martinez. Jessalyn Dale Mashburn. Jacob Ryan McGinnis. Devin Scott McIntyre. Landon Seth McIntyre. Angel Eduardo Nunez Alonzo. Gracie Nicole McCorder. Lakinja Jakala Miller. Bryson Jace Mitchell. Andrew Joseph Mooney. Michael James Moore. Jason Wayne Morris. Caleb Daniel Mullinax. Anna Catherine Nelson. Kalipo Malik Nelson. Mackenzie Summer Noland. Michelle Rodriguez Noriega. Dakota James Perdue. Tasha Lynette Peterson. Sydney Paige Phillips. Walker Lewis Phillips. Kendall Blake Pruitt. William Elijah Redding. And Traven Daquan Ridley. Savannah Hope Sambuco. Isabella Antoinette Sauls. Zoe Shane Sauls. Autumn Lee Scott. Raymond Lee Seegers. Connor Austin Sellers. Nathan Lane Shelnut. Harley Lynn Shope. Kenneth Reed Shope Jr. Lexi Grace Skinner. Lucas William Skinner. Brock Allen Smith. Crystal Blue Smith. Elijah Ollie Smith. Ray Douglas Smith. Sebastian Logan Camp Smith. Timothy Justin Smith. Caden Lee Spear. Carson Thomas Spears. Christian Meckel Spites. Catherine Elizabeth Steele. Devin Tyler Strength. Trevor Chase Strickland. Kelsey Lauren Sullivan. Bobby Jess Tankersley. Landon Elijah Taylor. Joseph Ashton Terry. Kaya Butterfly Thomas. Nakia Patrice Turner. Evan Samuel Sale Vaughn. Ariana Vera Marirez. Jackson Lee Warren. Anna Catherine Weaver. Caitlin Rhiannon Webb. Destiny Gabrielle Wester. Gracie Marie Whaley. Jonathan Samuel White. Haley Grace Wilkins. Jordan Garrett Williams. Callie Leanne Williamson. Deontay Urell Willis. Melissa Jean Wilson. Kylie Elizabeth Wimpy. Peyton Benjamin Woodard. Michael Ryan Woods. Caitlin Nicole Yarbrough. Deanna Jade Williamson. Byron Jameer Funes Martinez. Caleb Andrew Prater.
My name is Emma Davis, and I serve as class secretary. Seniors, at this time, please open your diploma cover and look for the alma mater. Please stand and sing with us. One more announcement. Parents and guests, please remain standing in your seats as faculty and graduates exit. Graduates will follow Mr. Griffiths and graduates seated on the stage, and junior marshals will release student rows from the floor. Seniors, the tassel ceremony is about to begin. With the turning of our tassels, we take the first step into our future as official graduates of Central High School. Please move your tassel from the right to the left. Congratulations, fellow graduates of Central High School. This concludes our commencement exercises. Thank you for coming. Good night.